What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. I am Eddie Wright, and today I'm here to basically give you a more detailed walk around of the new competition and concession trailer that you will be seeing, and talk about a few of the things that we have to, talk about a lot of the things we have to change in order to get ourselves ready for the universe of competition cooking and concessions. So, that being said, let's rewind the time back. A little bit back in late December, I started on a road trip and mental road trip of getting myself prepared to buy a trailer. My goal about 7 months ago was to start off 2020 into the barbecue competition circuit. And I'm glad to say that with the support of family, friends, and you, the general audience and culture of YouTube, that I've succeeded. I've been able to sustain a very generous private catering course, and it's most definitely helped push me a little bit further out here, and that led to me securing this 20-foot trailer with a 10-foot unenclosed porch. With that being said, this purchase was very important to me. I got it at a steal of a price. I will not say how much it was, but I did get it from a gentleman located about 2 hours from here. Shouts out to the Thrash family located in Laurel, Mississippi. But we got the deal done and immediately drove it back and had a lot of things to do. The last month has been a bit of an uphill battle, fixing issues that I didn't know about, and just kind of completing some things that were just minor errors and issues that I had to most definitely get taken care of with the trailer. I'll talk about those as I go through them. But while I'm inside, I'll kind of give you a run around. A concession window here that we'll use for when we're vending and even when we're competing. Has a lot of different additives to it already. Came with some amazing stainless steel tables that we'll be able to use. Shelving system will most definitely get an upgrade. The trailer came complete with pit lights, but we needed to replace those lights. So two on the driver's side and one on the passenger side by the concession window. That will be this right here. It helps light up the atmosphere for when we're doing concessions and we're doing catering, or even when we're at an event and people just want to have a lit atmosphere and feel safe. With that being said, we did have a few issues when we got in here. Our water heater here was not fully functional when we first got it. Our battery was not operational, so we did have to replace the battery. It's not rigged. This is how it came, but I will be adding a switch here. Somewhere here over probably to the left next to my controller for my tankless water heater to control the on off for it. I don't like it like it is now, and just want to be a lot bit safe. Here we have our clean tank and our dark tank. Dark tank most definitely looks like it needs a little TLC, so we'll go around, we'll do some little YouTube research, and we'll figure out what we need to do to get that cleaned out and ready to go, because we want to make sure it's able to drain when we want to hit that drain outside. We replaced our tankless heater with this system. It's an EcoTouch 5.5 kilowatt tankless system. When tested, the water functions and flows properly, but this led to the other problem. What we managed to find out was that our system is a 110 system interior. So we have to, another project we have to do is rewire the box to accept 220, and using that 220, we'll then be able to get full 220 volts to this tankless water heater to get us up to 100 degrees water. We have our sink here. We have a dream of a three sink system. I'm probably gonna lose my cabinets in order to do so. But when getting that sink system in here, it's gonna get us ready for our catering situation that we're wanting to most definitely have. My dream is to have a cutting board that covers it, or a compartment that covers it, so there's still usable space. I hate to cut into this great stainless table, but sometimes you gotta do what you gotta do for the love of barbecue. So, up top we have more shelving that will get upgraded. This is not terrible shelving, but I know during travel this is just not the most secure way to travel. So we'll change that. Here we have a 2-foot by 2-foot platform that will most definitely be used for a small refrigerator. I've already been researching those. So if you got any other suggestions or steals or deals, please let me know. Love to grab one here soon and just get the ball rolling. We'll go ahead and take this show outside and show you guys what else we got. Our trailer sits at an undisclosed location that I will not talk about for privacy reasons, but here we have the outside of it. It is a 10-foot enclosed, 10-foot porch. I hate saying enclosed because there's no sides to it. There's our back door. Back here, we're going to do quite a few things. This porch in this format allows us to move things on and off easy. this tailgate drops down. We have enough room here for a vertical, maybe a griddle. The Jimbo will most definitely go back here, but depending on what event or what catering event we're going to, we'll alternate what we have going on. We won't just load it up and leave it as is. We've got ample room on both left and right side of this, and we're most definitely going to outfit it properly. We're going to make sure we're able to get things on and off if we need to shift things on and off, and if we need to travel light or travel heavy, we got enough room and things back here to where we can strap it down to this amazing steel grate, hook it to these steel girders, and travel safe. One thing we also have to do, we have to get a very powerful generator, probably a 5,000 watt, to take care of our heating, our tankless heating needs, as well as power our entire system, because as I said, I've got some pretty crazy dreams. Maybe a 60 inch will go on the mount here over on this iron, this metal beam. Most definitely looking at some shades, some 6 foot shades to go on each side to give us a little bit more privacy, and just continuing to grow the look of this trailer in total. And we're just ready for the world, man. But I wanted to most definitely continue to keep you guys informed on what's going on. Every project here moving forward will be detailed and will be documented. I took a nice needed break for the new year. That's why you didn't get a new video at the beginning of 2020, but here moving forward, every Tuesday and Thursday, you'll be able to catch me here on the channel, here in your ear. So with that being said, thank you guys for always tuning into the channel. Thank you for liking and subscribing. If you haven't already, make sure you go ahead and do it today. Stay tuned for the amazing things we have coming forward here. And always remember, you too can do amazing barbecue the right way. Have a good one.